Hello friends, under business law, our topic is meaning and essential of an offer. A contract is a legally enforceable agreement. Agreement means offer and its acceptance. Offer means which is made by one party to another, and when the another party accepts it, then it becomes the agreement. So offer could be defined section 2A of the Contract Act when one person signified to another his willingness to do or not to do something with a view to obtaining the consent or assent of that other to such act or abstinence is called offer. Offer is a proposal which is made to another party. Section 2A reveals three essential elements in an offer: expression of willingness to do something. Like A made an offer to B for selling his steam car for rupees 1 lakh. So here A is making an offer to B to purchase the car of A for rupees 1 lakh, and not to do something. Like A owe money to B, A does not make the payment on the maturity date. B wanted to go to the court for suing the A, but A made an offer that he will pay 2% as additional interest if they don't go to the court. Or here the offer is made not to do something, not to go to the court, and which is made to another party. The intention is to gaining the consent of the other person to such act or abstinence. It is called the offer. The person who makes the offer is called the offerer, OFFER. And the person to whom the offer is made, that is called offeree. The offer could be expressed, it could be implied. Express offer is one which could be made by spoken words or by writing. Implied offer is gathered from the conduct or circumstances. Like you're stepping into some bus, then you have to make an offer. Make the payment of fare because it's an implied offer. When you step into the bus, it means you want to take the benefit of that bus. You have to make the payment of fare. You have accepted the implied offer. That has to be implied offer. That is gathered from the conduct or circumstances. Offer can be made to a particular person, can be made to a particular group or body of persons, and to the public offer. And first two, when it is made to particular person or to particular group or body of person, then it is a specific offer. Specific offer has to be accepted by those person to whom that offer is made. Specific offer can be made to definite person or body of person. It could be accepted by those person to whom the offer is made. When an offer is given to the whole world, then it is general offer. This is a very famous case on general offer. It is the Carlyle versus Carbolic Smoke Ball Company. Carbolic Smoke Company offered by advertisement that use our smoke ball 3 times daily for 2 weeks according to the printed direction. Still, if anybody has influenza, they will pay 100 pounds. Mrs. Carlyle used the smoke ball according to the given instruction, but still she contacted the influenza. She claimed 100 pounds, but the company refused that it was just a information. But the court said that it's a general offer, so it's not an invitation to offer. By following the instructions, she has accepted the offer. The company has to give her 100 pounds. Offer is a different from invitation to offer. Invitation to offer means just communication of the information. Like there is an advertisement in the newspaper, exhibition will be on particular date, sale will be on a particular date. If that sale does not happen, action does not happen, so you can't do anything. Even when you visit some shop, there is a display of goods, that is also invitation to offer. a mere communication of information is also not offered. Like you made some inquiry, you wanted to ask what is the price of that thing. That is just a communication of the information. A casual inquiry is also not an offer. A prospectus which invites the public to subscribe for the share and debentures of the company, that is also not an offer. Even when there is an advertisement for inviting the tender, that is also not an offer. What are the essentials of a valid offer? Offer must be capable of creating the legal relationship. If the party, they don't have any intention to create the legal relationship, then it is not a valid offer. Like in the case of Balofer versus Balofer, where the husband went to Ceylon and his wife was not able to come along, and he said he will make the payment of maintenance amount, but later on he did not make the payment. The wife went to the court and the court took the decision. It was not a legal agreement, it was a domestic agreement, so wife was not entitled to get the maintenance allowance. Offer must be certain, definite and not vague. The terms and condition of the offer should be clear. It should not be vague. Like in the case of Taylor versus Pottington, A agreed to take the house of B on rent for 3 years at a rent £85 if the house is renovated and decorated according to the present style. Here the terms and conditions were not clear, so the offer should be certain, terms and conditions should be properly clear, and offer should be made with a view to obtaining the assent of the other party. Both the parties, they should have the intention to create a legal relationship. If that intention is missing, then it is not a valid offer. Offer must be communicated to the offeree. If that offer is not communicated, then it is not a valid offer. Like in the case of Lalman Shukla versus Gauridat, D sent his servant to trace his missing nephew. After this, he announced that a reward will be given to the person who will provide the information about his missing nephew. His servant brought the nephew back and he demanded the reward. But the court declared that it was not communicated to the servant, so servant was not aware of the reward, so he is not entitled to get the reward. Offer may be conditional. Offer may contain some conditions. The acceptance should be subject to those conditions, and those conditions, they should be communicated at the time of offer is made. Offer should not contain a term the non-compliance of which would amount to acceptance. Like A made an offer to B, I want to sell my house for ₹20,000. If I don't receive a reply by Monday, I will think that you have accepted my offer. The offer should not contain the term the non-compliance of which would amount to acceptance. Invitation to offer is not an offer. Like this advertisement regarding the auction or sale, that is just an invitation to offer, that is not an offer, because here the information is communicated, not an offer is made. Counter offer means when there is a rejection of the original offer and then new offer is made, then original offer is accepted, then it will not be a valid. Like in the case of Hyde versus Ranch, A offered to sell a farm for ₹1,000, but B said he would give 950. So here he rejected the offer, he made a counter offer, but A refused. Then he said he will give £1,000. So it is not a valid offer. It's not a valid offer. A could reject this offer also. Cross offer, when two parties make identical offer to each other in ignorance of each other's offer. Like A made an offer to B by sending a letter to him that I want to purchase your house for 40,000. B, ignorant of this offer, he also made an offer by writing a post to A that he is interested in selling his house to for 40,000. So there is a cross offer that is also not a valid offer and acceptance. Communication of special conditions. If the offer contains some conditions, they should be communicated at the time of the offer is made. And here the one party cannot take the benefit that he is uneducated, he is blind. So special conditions, they should be communicated at the time of the offer is made. Like in the case of Parker versus South Eastern Railway, P deposited his bag at the clock room at railway station and received a ticket on where it was clearly written C bag. On the bag, it was a condition: the organization is not responsible for any loss of baggage. If there is a loss of baggage, they will pay the compensation only to the tune of £10. And his bag is lost. And he went to the court, but the court said that you are entitled to get only £10. The offer lapses if either of the party, offerer or offeree, dies before the acceptance. If it is not accepted with a reasonable time or some specified time is given, then the offer lapses. Then offer is made but it is accepted with some condition, then the offer is also not validly accepted. When A made an offer to B, but before B making the acceptance, he withdraw his offer, then it is lapses by the revocation, by the cancellation.